Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back. I'm sorry, it's very loud in the chicken pit. But I wanted to show you my chicken pit. This is my chicken pit. So, I got a couple of things going on, and I'll explain what's going on. So, this is my chest. What you do is you put eggs in this chest, and then this dropper shoots them at the chickens. Let me go get some more eggs so I can show you the whole operation. So, this here is a chest that normally the eggs drop into. Eggs in there right now. Figure it out. This is my chicken pen. Inside here are where these contain arrows. When you fire this up, it kills all the chickens or anything that's in there and turns them into lovely, lovely meat, which is collected and they show up right in here. It's very annoying. There's lots of them in there, so let's cull the herd a little bit. Chicken murder! Chicken murder! Murder some chicken! Or ducks, I'm not sure. Okay, so I murdered some chickens. If I go back down to the bottom of it. There's one egg. There's lots of raw chicken coming through. And I've got some cooked chicken there. Let's go back up there and go to the kitchen. So, this is a pulsing generator. This creates a pulse using redstone. There's two redstone torches and some redstone dust. These delay the pulse and they slow it down. And this is a dropper that just throws anything that you load into here. It goes right into that dropper. Throws it at the ducks, chickens, whatever they are. Sometimes makes tiny ducks. That's how you reproduce the ducks there. So let's go in here. This is where I sleep. I close the door. Come here and close the door. And this is my magic room here. I got my magic book where I enchant things on there. And this is the magic room there. I'm gonna close that door. And this is where I make arrows here. I drop off the feathers here. These are feathers that are used to make arrows. And this is my food. So I drop off the cooked chickens. And I don't have any more eggs out of that. That's where I make stuff. And this is where I cook the chickens. If you take fuel, and I do like using, I put these furnaces on the ground floor so they don't take up any visual space. They look kind of look like tiles, and when they're cooking, they light up a little bit. You can see that. So I'm gonna get my cooked chickens. On this particular server, they have warps set up. So you hear that? And I have my warp set up, so I can actually warp over to my tower. And my tower has no chicken sounds in it. Don't leave the gate open. So I'm selling chickens here, cooked chickens, and I'm just stocking this up here. And this is so anyone in-game can come in here and click on this wooden sign, and then I will get $10, and then they can sell me a chicken for $2 if they want. I gotta fix that sign. I probably should fix it. I won't fix it right now. I'm gonna look that up. I don't want to bore you too much. Where I do some stuff, gather my feathers, the rotten flesh, and then I go back to the lava base. Yes, this is SDF. I wonder if there's any new eggs in here. Let's see. No eggs are green. It's kind of weird. I used to have lots of eggs. Maybe I need to reset it. Okay, time to murder everyone. Chicken murder, chicken murder, chicken murder, murder the chickens. Murder the chickens. Murder them all, because they're chickens. Can't get it. Okay, so you can see I've got these funnel things. I forget what Minecraft calls them. But they funnel everything straight down. If I show you, this is the down below. These all four feed into this slot, and everything goes into that. It's a hopper. It's a hopper. So everything feeds down into that chest. So anything that dies here, or anything that appears in this 3x3 little room, goes down into that chest for collection. And that's. I'll demonstrate if I put this one egg in here. You can see that it shoots it toward the bottom, and whenever you throw an egg, there's a certain chance that that egg will turn into a baby chick. And if you give it enough time, the baby chick grows up, and then you can have a full chick, and they will lay eggs there's under certain conditions. Okay, so first, put away the feathers. Have some more feathers. We can make some more arrows. And then we got some cooked chicken. We put some chicken in here. This is where the food is kept. Got more feathers. Wish I could give me one of those auto sorting generator things, but I just don't have the stuff right now. Okay, so I showed you my magic room. And there's my empty. I don't know why I have that there. This is my magic room where the magic notes come fly into the magic book. And you can enchant items that you build. Yeah, I probably should enchant my armor. My armor, that needs some. I need some work. So, in this version of the game, what you can do is you can actually take off your I'm going to take off all my armor there. See, you got my Fallout skin going on. Woot! I love my Fallout. And say my helmet has projection or protection from projectiles, which I think is arrows. So if you put this in the center square and you put some iron ingots there, takes away an iron ingot, but now it's all up to full health, so I guess I can't do that with that plate. I guess it's not damaged enough. Let's try this, maybe? Can I? No? See that? I can repair. That takes away one. Can I repair this? How about my iron lining? Can I do that? Do I need more? No, I guess I can't repair those things. So you can see the green bar on here. It's got some damage to it, but now that these are back up 100%. Don't drop your iron leggings. Put them back on. Put on your clothes. Put your armor back on, because monsters will kill you. Okay, so I'm a little bit better there. So I'm gonna build. I can show you. This game is very thin. This game is very calming. It's very interesting because I'll enchant my axe because I've got a lot of enchant iron. I should put that up. I got some feathers there. Okay. So I'm gonna enchant that axe, but first I'm gonna prepare it up to full health. So there, bop. There, that's at full health now. Then I'm gonna take it in here. The door. Don't want to do magic with the door closed. Okay, so I take this item and I say, put some magic on it. Oh, wait, I forgot. There's something you have to do in Minecraft. You have to use some lapis lazuli. And I'm probably saying that wrong. Way wrong. You have to pump this in here. This is how you enchant items. Now I can get Unbreaking 3. Now, you can see it's got Unbreaking 1 on there. That's the enchantment that's on it. So now it'll last longer. The axe won't go away as quick. Okay. Super exciting times. And because I don't want to lose my metal, I'm going to put my metal away there. See my glorious, beautiful face. My facial region. Don't fall in the lava. That's bad. Tip from your Uncle Techie. Don't fall in the lava. Lava bad. Oh, that's an interesting sound. Who's saying that to me? Again, there's a little coal for you. Coal mining. Walking against the water you can do it, but you be careful, it doesn't push you into the lava, because then lava burns you and you die. So try not to die in the lava. Recommend against it. As a strategy, it's a bad idea. So all this time while I'm wandering in this cave and exploring this cave and walked around here, I've forgotten where I've been. Yeah, never do this. Never dig straight up because you might die. Or don't ever do this. Don't ever dig straight down because you could die and tunnel right into lava and then you're screwed. Don't ever do what I'm doing right now. That's very unlucky. It's kind of dark here, so lighten it up. There we go. I can see a little better now. So I showed you in my main base there, the lava base, I call it. There's a big thing of lava coming down the wall. See how I can hear that boobling? That boobling is probably lava. There's probably lava real close. Don't want to tunnel into lava because that's bad. Oh, there's redstone. That's how you mine redstone there. When you strike redstone with an implement, it glows a little bit, and then it goes dark. I don't know if there's a correlation between the redstone and where the diamonds are. Oh, see? There we have. We have lava sign. See that? See those little things orange? I might like to get this piece of iron, but right above it, that iron ore, there's a lava river. That's exactly what you don't do. Don't ever do that, kids. And I'm screwed. Good thing I dug that thing right there, I would have died. Lava would have come right at me and burned me, and I would have been toast. Literally toasted. See, there's lava all around me. There's lava all around me. I see the way it flows. If you're not protected, it'll get on your clothes. Yeah, so don't let the lava get you. It's bad. So very nice. Illuminates nicely. But burny sensation. Not really a good idea. Are you still around? I'm going to decay. There we go. Okay. So that's the bedrock level. So if you mine all your way down to bedrock, there's a good chance you will find around the bedrock level, you will find where the diamonds are. So you're going to avoid tunneling into the lava. There's lava on your head, it makes you dead. And if you are dead, you can't pick up the diamonds, and that's really this game is all about the economics, you know. So we have some more a redstone sign. But you're probably not going to find any diamonds embedded in the bedrock. That's probably a little false flag. This is just bedrock. You can hit this with a hammer all day long, and it's not going anywhere. Unless you're in creative mode, and then what's the point of playing in creative mode? So I like to dig these long 4 or 5. Yeah, if I go like that. No lava, no lava. Oh, look, there's air up there. There we go. Try not to stand on things when you're mining them, because if there's lava beneath them or a big fall, then, again, you'll die. And I realize that I'm saying a lot of things that are very, very obvious and simplistic, and that's because I'm not like a pro Minecraft gamer. I just play for fun. You know, I'm not like one of these uber elite Minecraft kids who've been playing Minecraft for, you know, since the day it came out, and it wasn't even a Microsoft product. It was before Notch sold it to Microsoft. Actually, I was playing before Notch sold it to Microsoft.